This is a demonstration video following the steps of the Sawstop Professional Mobile Base Installation Guide. That's a mouthful. Unless you need to install a Sawstop Professional Mobile Base, there's nothing else much that would be interesting for you here. The first thing is to roll the saw off the pallet onto the top piece of foam. Make sure that the base overhangs, and I would remove that plastic wrap at this point to make your life easier too. The installation manual is 9 pages, and after flipping through it, I immediately started to gloss over. Naturally, I went straight to YouTube to find an instruction video, found none. If only I could send videos back in time. Step 2, acquire these tools because they don't come with the mobile base. Step 3, attach the linkage bar. Note that the caster support has a mounting shoulder and that goes to the far side. You can get that part going the wrong way. If you don't have metric Allen keys, there's some in another blister pack somewhere else in the saw. Step 4, mount the caster support with the mounting shoulder down, like this. As you can see, I didn't overhang the saw on the foam far enough to easily get to that screw hole. Step 5 and 6 are installing those screws. Step 7, attach a wheel to the end of the wheel support that has a mounting shoulder and put a nut on it. Step 8. The wheel on the other end of the wheel support gets no nut at this stage. Step 9. Remove the shoulder bolt from the pedal assembly. And poke it into the saw. Step 10, reattach the shoulder bolt and install the spring. The end of the spring with the hook goes onto the shoulder bolt. Step 11, install the wheel assembly. Mounting shoulder down. Make sure this is behind the pedal assembly. Step 12, screw the wheel assembly in using the bottom screw only. Step 13, and this is the hardest step, attach the wheel assembly to the pedal assembly like this with a wheel axle nut. This is where you need the metric socket spanner. Step 14, and you're nearly there. Screw the wheel support in at the top. Step 15, attach the pedal assembly to the linkage bar with a shoulder socket screw. At this point, test that the mechanism works as expected like this. Step 16, stand the saw up. Careful, I recommend that you need 2 people lifting because it's heavy and slippery with oil. Thank you. Attach the caster extension bar to the caster support arms. Step 17. Attach the caster support plate and you're going to need 2 10-mil spanners. Step 18, attach the casters. And these need a 14mm wrench. Congratulations, you've done it. I made this look easy, but I had to work it out all beforehand, so it really was a big job. If you want to see the rest of the saw assembled, check out my unboxing and review video. There's a link in the description. Thanks.